logs for that fire.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
That's not that bad.
These characters burst on the scene in 2000 during Super Bowl 34.
Was Yo, what y'all doing?
Just watching the game, having a bud. What's up with you?
Watching the game, having a bud.
Yes! What game are you watching?
Yes! It doesn't get more magical than this.
This is Brett.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Just watching the market recap.
The following year, they spoofed themselves as yuppies.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Hey, Brett, who's that?
Hey, Chad, pick up the cordless. Chad here.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Hey, it's Michael Malley. Yeah, I'm here at the stadium, and I know I'm supposed to go down the sideline and do some reporting for the game. I got a crew here with me, and it doesn't seem like the game is on right now. Yeah, I know, but the stadium is completely empty. The game's supposed to start in 15 minutes. Oh, that's Sunday. My bad. All right. We could do this greatest commercial special thing. I hosted it before. And anyways, coming up at number 9, Super Bowl's greatest commercials, we got Broadway Joe Namath and Farrah Fawcett long before she became one of Charlie's Angels. Check it out.
I'm so excited. I'm gonna get creamed.
Yeah, yeah.
Let Moxie Mock cream your face.
The closer you shave, the more you need creamy, soothing, medicated Noxzema.
Let Noxzema cool your face. So the razor don't.
You've got a great pair of hands.
Hey everyone, it's your boy P. Diddy, hanging out at the lounge on the club level at Reliance Stadium. As you can see, the party has not begun yet, but tomorrow is going down. And I'm here to give you the heads up that you can see me, your boy P. Diddy, Janet Jackson, and Nelly, and also Kid Rock perform tomorrow at this year's Super Bowl halftime show. That's going to be crazy, y'all. There's no bigger spectacle on the earth than the Super Bowl. The game, the entertainment, and of course, the commercials. The funniest spots you've ever seen have been made first, and they've appeared first right here on the Super Bowl. So check these out. Have a laugh.
Hello.
Come home early.
Oh, I can't. I'm working.
I lit some candles.
I'm swamped.
I bought Bud Light.
Seven.
Oh! Oh! For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
20 over 60.
Is he on any medication?
None.
Doctor, I think you should see this.
How much?
Why, what is it?
He's got money coming out the wazoo.
What do we have?
Money out the wazoo.
Move this man to a private room.
Out of the way, this man's got money coming out the wazoo.
Does your husband have insurance?
Insurance? He's got money coming out of the wazoo.
Oh.
It's time for E-Trade.
So I hear things are getting pretty serious with you and Sarah.
Yeah, I'm actually meeting her mother for the first time tonight.
We'll get a good look at her, because in 20 years, that's what Sarah's gonna look like.
What do you mean?
Take a good look at her. That's what Sarah's gonna look like.
Oh. Hi.
Hi.
This is my mom.
Hi, so nice to meet you.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down.
Isn't she incredible?
Yeah.
Make it a Bud Light.
This commercial for beer ran during last year's Super Bowl, as it was seen in Australia.
Are going to the Super Bowl! You get the tickets, the trip's on me! Miami.
Dana and John were psyched. Dana took the American Express card.
But John took that other card. John had trouble at the airport.
What? I'm over my limit?
Sorry.
Do you take American Express?
Of course.
Yes!
At the stadium.
Oh, let me at least pay for the ticket.
Hey, wait a minute.
That card's no good here.
I thought the TV ad said you took it!
Finally, John found the one place at the Super Bowl that takes that other card. The souvenir stand.
You got me this with your card?
Yeah. Thanks.
The American Express card. Don't leave home without it.
Dana Carvey and John Lovitz made it to that Super Bowl, but I'll be in this one. Let's pick up the countdown at number 8.
Suelto cada momento que siento correcto y lo hago completo y directo. Sí, señor. Sí, señor.
Number 7, Mountain Dew.
Bad cheetah.
See? That's why I'm not a cat person.
Don't go away. The countdown has just begun. When we return, Super Bowl's sexiest commercials, plus guest appearances by Aerosmith, Steven Tyler, and Joe Perry.
We're going to tear it up tomorrow at the Super Bowl pregame show.
Super Bowl's greatest commercials, sponsored by the all-new AOL 9.0 Optimized. Call 1-800-4-ONLINE to sign up today.
I'm gonna win this poll, Mikey.
Well, do we have monkeys?
No monkeys.
What about aliens?
No aliens.
How about explosions?
Explosions are good.
And cut.
Oh, yeah, we're good.
Great job, ladies.
Way to go, Laverne.
This new quilted northern is fabulous.
It's not every day we come up with the softest quilted northern ever.
You really can see and feel the difference.
Only new quilted northern has a top sheet with new improved quilting for extra softness and a second layer that's velvety soft.
Time for close-ups.
Of us?
No, of the two new layers.
New quilted northern. It's all in the quilting.
With Celebrex, I will no longer give in to the joint pain of osteoarthritis. With Celebrex, I will not stop at 9 when I really want to play 18.
These are just a few of the 23 million people who have discovered Celebrex. Celebrex has proven strength. In fact, doctors prescribe Celebrex more than any other brand. Just one Celebrex provides up to 24 hours of relief from the pain of osteoarthritis. One pill, 24 hours.
With Celebrex, I will not settle for part-time relief.
Celebrex should not be taken if you've had aspirin-sensitive asthma or allergic reactions due to aspirin or other arthritis medicines or certain drugs called sulfonamides. In rare cases, serious stomach problems such as bleeding can occur without warning. Tell your doctor if you have kidney or liver problems.
If you are struggling with joint pain, maybe you should stop trying to manage it by yourself. Ask your doctor about Celebrex. Take control of your joint pain with the proven strength of Celebrex.
With Celebrex, I will not give in.
I don't have any. Sorry.
Can't find new Ritz chips?
Guess they're even more popular than we thought. We're making them as fast as we can.
What do you mean I can't get any Ritz chips? I'm the spokesman. Hamilton. George Hamilton. All right, I'll hold.
Everybody loves Raymond. Mondays on CBS. It's all here.
See why CBS Thursday is the best night of television. A chilling murder.
Jugular's been punctured.
Fangs. Leads to a bloodthirsty killer.
You found evidence of vampires.
For you.
A new CSI. Then, a bounty hunter goes missing.
I know her. Worked a couple of cases together.
Now we have two of her callers that claim she's dirty.
Now this agent not only has to find her, he's got to defend her innocence.
You gonna shoot me?
I am seriously considering it.
A new Without a Trace. After a new CSI. CBS Thursday.
The greatest moves. The greatest hits. The greatest come to play on CBS.
Feel good, right?
There's only one place you can find the Super Bowl. Music's biggest night. The Grammys. Two great events. One great network. CBS. Where the greatest come to play.
Welcome back to Super Bowl's greatest commercials from beautiful Reliance Stadium here in Houston, site of Super Bowl 38 tomorrow on CBS. Certainly a lot of excitement here in Houston about tomorrow's game, but also a lot of anticipation here about the Houston Astros baseball team, because two home heroes are coming back to pitch for the Astros. First, it was Andy Pettitte deciding not to return to the Yankees and sign with the Astros. Then he coaxed his friend and mentor, Roger Clemens, out of his short retirement to come and also join the pitching staff. So, you know, together the two of them have won six world championships. It's only fitting, I guess, then, that we would ask them to show you our sixth greatest Super Bowl commercial of all time. I give you Houston's very own Andy Pettitte and Roger Clemens.
Thanks, Jim. Yes, Houston is pretty charged. Not only are we hosting this year's Super Bowl, but the 2004 All-Star Baseball game will be played at our new home, Minute Maid Park, in July. So the city's got plenty to be pumped about.
We're here tonight to talk about commercials, specifically the ones you voted as sixth and fifth all time. Both of them use special effects and hit home runs with our viewers.
Number 5, McElhaney Tabasco Sauce.
Aerosmith will be performing here at Reliance Stadium in the pregame show tomorrow, but tonight we catch up with them at NASA. Here are Steven Tyler and Joe Perry.
Rock and roll and football are what America is all about. Both are loud, full of sweet emotion, and not afraid to get a little bit ugly. And like Bradshaw and Swan, or fishnets and high heels, rock and roll and football make a hell of a team.
And there ain't much the team likes more than fast cars and fast women.
Luckily, the commercials that are on during the Super Bowl feature hot heaping helpings of both. And on that note, here's to a little loving an elevator. Let's have a look-see.
If Michael Jordan is the king of Super Bowl commercials, Cindy Crawford is the undisputed queen. Her sex appeal is so enduring that this 1992 spot was remade 9 years later, showing Cindy as a supermom with her own two children.
Is that a great new Pepsi can or what?
Introducing a whole new way to look at Pepsi and Diet Pepsi.
It's beautiful.
Honey, I've got the black teddy on.
Yeah, okay.
And I put the satin sheets on the bed.
Yeah, be up in a minute.
I've got cold Bud Light.
This Bud Light spot from 2002 was one of the most popular in Super Bowl 36.
Ow.
Honey?
This 1998 spot for Doritos was the first of three straight Super Bowl TV commercial appearances for former Miss USA, Allie Landry.
A whole new shape that begs to be eaten in very loud ways.
One of her co-stars is Sean Hayes, just before Will and Grace rocketed him to fame.
I Chihuahua.
Doritos 3D snacks.
Hi, I need to pick up my car.
And you are?
Yasmin, please.
Okay.
Hi.
Hey.
Can you spell that, please?
B-L-E-E-T-H.
There.
You know, maybe I should just come back another time.
No. Not good. Oh, no.
It will be done.
Soon. Can you spell that again, please?
The halftime show is being produced tomorrow by MTV. They have been a part of the entertainment landscape all week long in Houston. And you'll see TRL at the Super Bowl on CBS tomorrow at 12 noon Eastern time. Now, let's get back to the countdown and send it over to a man who is no stranger to countdowns, the host of TRL. Here's Damian.
Thanks, Jim. You got a killer view from up there. And down here, we are actually on the Houston Texans practice field. And this is the site of TRL on CBS tomorrow, where we're going to have a performance by Jessica Simpson. Her husband, Nick Lachey, is going to stop by. Even P. Diddy is going to make an appearance right here tomorrow. And a guest so big that we can't tell you right now. Let me just put it that way. Back to the countdown, though. At number four, the legendary Apple 1984 spot from Super Bowl 18. Now, this historic spot, celebrating its 20th anniversary, only aired once. And it is credited for launching a new era in Super Bowl commercials.
The day we celebrate the first glorious anniversary of the information purification directives. We have created, for the first time in all history, a garden of pure ideology where each worker may bloom, secure from the pests of a contradictory. Is more powerful a weapon than any fleet or army on earth. We are one people, with one will, one resolve, one cause. Our enemies shall talk themselves to death, and we will bury them with their own confusion. We shall prevail.
On January 24th, Apple Computer will introduce Macintosh. And you'll see why 1984 won't be like 1984.
By the way, film director Ridley Scott, who created that Apple 1984 commercial, also directed such important films as one of my favorites, Gladiator. Speaking of gladiators, I can guarantee you one person who didn't see that spot air is my NFL Today partner here, the MVP of Super Bowl 18 back in 1984, Hall of Famer Marcus Allen.
Thanks, Jim. Good to see you.
Good to see you. And that run you had, that breathtaking run for the touchdown, spinning around, how often do you get reminded of that?
Every Super Bowl, Jim. It's one of the most magical runs of my life, and I never forget about it.
Speaking of magic, any commercials from the Super Bowl through the years that kind of stand out in your mind?
Oh, this is easy. This is the Mean Joe Green commercial with that little kid. He hands him the Coca-Cola. Joe looks down, and the kid says, "Thanks, Mean Joe." That was magic,
that was
too.
Good stuff. It was inspirational.
It was, very.
Thanks, Marcus. Now, while we celebrate the 20th anniversary of that groundbreaking Apple commercial, let's take a look at some of the other commercial spots that ran back in Super Bowl 18 that, well, should we say, haven't withstood the test of time.
Chevrolet is taking charge of one hot experience no other 2 plus 2 can touch.
Chevy Camaro went the futuristic route with this spot, but the results were more like a bad music video than a good car commercial.
Yet priced under $8,000, priced to light your fire.
Chevrolet!
In
than you.
Taking charge.
Thanks to new technology.
Car phones were so new when this spot aired in Super Bowl 18. They were still almost the size of the football used in the game.
And there'll be no more waiting for an operator to place your call. You just direct dial it yourself.
Hello.
Also, you'll eventually be able to transmit not only voice, but any communications that can be carried over telephone lines.
Gee.
Bill Bixby was a major star from the TV series The Incredible Hulk. But this Tandy commercial looked more like his earlier hit series, My Favorite Martian.
It's faster, with higher resolution, more storage, and greater expandability than IBM's PC. The Tandy TRS-80 Model 2000 personal computer. The dawn of a new era in personal computing.
Life is still a bachelor.
Tomorrow's almost here.
So while you're still a free man, let's bring on the beer.
Bowl! Bowl!
Although this Schlitz beer spot aired in 1984, it used popular music groups from the 60s and 70s. Both are still performing around the country, but thankfully not making commercials like this anymore.
Don't say beer, say bull!
Hey, gang, how about another bull?
No one does it like the bull!
They don't make them like they used to, and we're all thankful for that. We're down to three. And now we invite you to log on to AOL.com or CBS.com and cast your vote for the greatest Super Bowl commercial ever. We'll have the announcement of the winner shortly. Now here we go. The final three spots you're voting on, Budweiser Zebra Referee.
Referee's a jackass.
No, I believe that's a zebra.
Coca-Cola's Mean Joe Green.
Mr. Green? Mr. Green?
Yeah.
You need any help?
Mm-mm.
I just want you to know, I think you're the best ever.
Yeah, sure.
Want my Coke? It's okay, you can have it.
No.
Really, you can have it.
Okay.
A Coke Thanks. And a smile makes me feel good. Makes me feel nice.
Be around.
That's the way it should be. I like to see.
Hey, kid.
The whole world smiling with me. Coca-Cola has life. Have a Coke.
Mean Joe.
Smile.
And McDonald's, Jordan versus
Lunch.
Bird.
Big Mac, fries. Play you for it. You and me for my Big Mac.
First one to miss watches a winner eat. No dunking.
One meat. Which meat? Get in there.
Off the floor, off the scoreboard, off the bang board, no rim.
Over the second rafter, off the floor, nothing but net. Through the window, off the wall, nothing but net.
What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Off the expressway, over the river, off the billboard, through the window, off the wall, nothing but net.
Log on now to AOL.com or CBS.com and vote for the greatest Super Bowl commercial of all time. Coming up, an exclusive sneak peek at some of the most talked about commercials debuting in tomorrow's game.
Hello, everything looks wonderful. Oh, I didn't forget about you, sweetie.
Hey, great party.
George, how are you?
Good.
Hi.
Hello.
Michael, I...
Your dog has very sophisticated taste.
Thank you.
Caesar, sophisticated food for sophisticated dogs.
Oh.
What's the matter, Frank?
Why'd I eat that pizza?
You love pizza.
I knew I'd get heartburn.
Didn't you start taking Prilosec?
Yeah, but it can take 1 to 4 days to fully kick in.
That's a long time to wait, Frank.
Oh!
Prilosec OTC is not for fast relief. It can take 1 to 4 days to fully work. Zantac 75 works fast, right when you need it, even at night when heartburn can be at its worst. Zantac, fast heartburn relief for people who hate to wait.
Oh!
Bob, you're snoring. Bob?
Hi, Daddy.
Hey, sweetheart. I miss you.
I miss you, too.
What did you do today?
I played soccer.
For your most important calls, reach out on the wireless service America trusts. AT&T Wireless.
What a time for a migraine. 3 restless kids and no way out. My migraine wasn't going anywhere either. So I decided to talk to my doctor. He gave me a prescription for Imitrex.
Prescription Imitrex targets your total migraine, the pain, nausea, sensitivity to light and sound, for the relief you need without drowsiness. Imitrex is not right for everyone or every migraine. If you have certain types of heart or blood vessel disease or uncontrolled blood pressure, you shouldn't take Imitrex. Very rarely, certain people, even some without heart disease, have had serious heart-related problems. So talk to your doctor, especially if you have risk factors for heart disease, such as smoking, high blood pressure, or high cholesterol, or if you are pregnant, nursing, or taking medication.
You can't put life on hold for a migraine.
Ask your doctor about Imitrex. And now there's good news. You can get your first full prescription of Imitrex for free. To find out more, call this number or visit Imitrex.com. Target your total migraine with Imitrex and get back to your life.
They're the best of the best. Former survivors.
I'm back.
Compete in the ultimate survivor showdown.
I may not be the youngest, but don't bet against me.
They think they know every trick in the book.
I have a very low tolerance for stupidity.
But we've saved the biggest twists just for them.
I've been waiting for this.
18 former castaways returning to play the ultimate game one more time.
Survivor All-Stars premieres CBS Sunday after the Super Bowl.
CBS Super Monday. Kick off your week with brand new episodes of TV's most watched comedy lineup. Everyone's a winner on CBS Super Monday.
The greatest come to play, the Grammys, live CBS Sunday, February 8th. Welcome back to Super Bowl's greatest commercials.
For the biggest advertisers in the world, the Super Bowl has evolved into the Ego Bowl. They all have their egos at stake. What do they want? To be the one ad that's talked about on Monday morning.
These big muscles need some tenderizing.
Okay, cutie, rim 5.
Thank you.
Ooh. Once again, the most important Super Bowl advertiser and advertisements to watch belong to Anheuser-Busch. These beer guys know how to be funny.
Since I was born, I dreamed of being a Budweiser Clydesdale. Only problem is, I was born a donkey.
Must be tough being a big-time basketball player.
Must be tough.
Must be tough being a mega-hit singer.
Must be tough.
Designated driver.
Another very important spot to look for in tomorrow's Super Bowl is one from Pepsi. What they take is a young Jimi Hendrix, about 11 years old, walking down the street, and here's the classic duel. He sees a Pepsi machine on one side, Coke machine on the other side. He chooses one, and watch what happens after he does.
Already the talent in front of the camera, like Cindy Crawford, Michael Jordan. Now we'd like to introduce you to one of the most influential men behind the lens, legendary commercial director Joe Pitka and his team. Just how influential is Joe Pitka? He has been in more Super Bowls than Joe Montana, than John Elway, than Terry Bradshaw, than all of them combined.
Super Bowl is a fantastic stage for advertising. People do go all out to do really fabulous commercials for the Super Bowl. You're asking how many Super Bowl commercials I've done? Maybe more than 100. We did Air Jordan with Bugs Bunny. Well, the prettiest one was Cindy Crawford, because Cindy Crawford's the most beautiful girl ever. Michael Jordan and Larry Bird for McDonald's. The only thing I can remember from the shoot is Larry Bird never missed a shot. My favorite Pepsi spot on the Super Bowl was the one we did a couple years ago with Britney Spears, where she recreated a whole bunch of old Pepsi commercials. I thought she was brilliant. We did the Dancing Bears commercial for Pepsi. That commercial was almost a parody of a commercial. And this idea, I think, is stronger than that idea. This idea is very sophisticated, very complicated in a way. They're very simple, they're very funny. And there's a human element here that we didn't have in the other bear commercial. The idea is the bears come upon a cabin. They find a wonderful amount of food in the refrigerator. And they start to have a feast. They realize something is missing. Cut to a convenience store.
Stand by. Action.
The bears come in and buy some Pepsi. But there's a punchline that I'm not going to tell you.
Two different shots. First one is the one bear looking around.
The big bear, I mean, his head is as big as this chair.
Why don't you get into your close-up?
I love this spot. I love this commercial. The idea is hysterically funny.
Somebody laugh.
For better or for worse, the best advertising on the Super Bowl has been by these visionary people, whether it's Pepsi or Budweiser or whoever else has had a high impact. I'm sure there's a singular voice saying, let's do the best work possible. I don't really care what it costs. Let's just get it out there and do it as well as possible, which is not a bad philosophy for everything.
Our friends from The Early Show have been in Houston all week in anticipation of Super Bowl 38, and let's go over to them right now.
Thanks, Jim. I'm Hannah Storm, along with Dave Price, here at the NFL Experience. You know, reviewing the best Super Bowl commercials the Monday morning after the Super Bowl, that's one of our favorite things to do.
Love it.
We love doing that on The Early Show. So, of course, we're delighted to be with you this evening for a look back at some of the very best animal commercials of all time.
Now, when we say animals, so that can include shellfish and, of course, mammals and insects, creatures that don't even exist anymore, like dinosaurs and dodos.
Dodos?
Dodos. Now, not all of these animals are real, and some of them can even talk. Take a look.
Put it down, man. Guess I'll have the steak.
Stanley Kubrick's classic film 2001, A Space Odyssey, was clearly the inspiration for this Sierra Mist commercial.
Sierra Mist. Taste one shockingly refreshing lemon-lime.
Being a cat herder is probably about the toughest thing I think I've ever done.
I got this one this morning, right here. And if you look at his face, it's just ripped to shreds, you know?
You see the movies, you hear the stories, I'm living a dream. Not everyone can do what we do.
I wouldn't do nothing else.
It ain't an easy job, but when you bring a herd into town and you ain't lost a one of them, ain't a feeling like it in the world.
EDS, managing the complexities of the digital economy.
This 1999 spot is about two Dalmatian puppies separated at birth. One seemingly gets adopted into better circumstances than the other and lets his sibling know it. 2 years later, their paths cross again with unexpected results.
Once again, friends, a quick reminder, it is time to go online and cast your vote for the greatest Super Bowl commercial in history. It is completely your call. Log on to AOL.com or CBS.com and choose among the following three finalists. Of course, Coca-Cola, Mean Joe Green, the Budweiser Zebra spot, or McDonald's, Larry Bird versus Michael Jordan.
There's still time to cast your vote for your favorite Super Bowl commercial by logging on to AOL.com or CBS.com. When we return, Dion, Boomer, and Dan weigh in, and we'll crown your pick for the favorite Super Bowl commercial of all time.
Do you know that they vote on these commercials?
Yeah, Pop, I'm aware of that.
So then don't mess it up.
Time, but now that new Prilosec OTC is here.
We're gonna spread the word.
Yes, indeedy. Hey, you okay?
Heartburn, the third day this week.
Start taking this tomorrow and things can change.
Prilosec OTC.
One pill a day can relieve frequent heartburn for 24 hours.
I could have zero heartburn.
And it starts working the very first day.
Prilosec OTC!
One pill a day,
24 hours,
zero heartburn.
I gotta win this poll, Mikey.
Do we have monkeys?
No monkeys.
How about explosions?
Explosions are good.
Super Bowl's greatest commercials will continue here on CBS.
TV's two biggest events are on CBS Super Sunday. The world will be watching when the Patriots and the Panthers battle it out in Super Bowl 38. Then, after the game, the favorite castaways of all time will compete in the ultimate showdown, Survivor All-Stars. Yeah! It all begins Sunday, only on CBS.
When there's a full moon over Miami, the strangest things happen.
He called 911.
In other words, our victim called in his own murder.
A new CSI Miami, Monday.
Catch Dave's Super Bowl wrap-up, Monday on an all-new Late Show.
In his State of the Union speech, here's what George Bush should have said about his new Medicare bill.
My fellow Americans, my Medicare bill has real drug benefits, but not for you, for my contributors at the big drug companies. My bill actually forbids Medicare from negotiating lower drug prices, so you'll probably have to pay more for your prescriptions than you do now. And you won't be able to get cheaper prescriptions from Canada.
The Bush Medicare sellout. It's enough to make you sick.
Presenting the 245 horsepower all-wheel drive Nissan Murano, an SUV for the wilds of civilized society.
The CBS 47 News Troubleshooters, uncovering more details.
All right, Michael Malley back here again. I finally caught up with what we're doing here. We've been counting down Super Bowl's greatest commercials, and we're going to get to number one in a moment, but let's talk for a second about sports and how sports and the theme of sports have really influenced so many Super Bowl commercials. Check it out.
Have you ever spent like 5 minutes with him? He's totally self-centered and insensitive. They just don't go together. I mean, she's my best friend. She has these emotional needs he can't meet. Remember what she went through with Brad? It was just like awful. And now he's the one acting needy?
He's at the 50. He's at the 40. He's gonna go all the way. Johnson breaking loose. The rookie's on fire. Wow, this kid's having a huge half. It's just incredible.
You're such a great listener.
Thanks.
Budweiser has long used Clydesdales in its commercials, but never like this.
they always do that?
Nah, they usually go for two.
Can I write a check?
Yo.
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 Can I write a check?
Yo.
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 Yo. Can I write a check?
Yo.
Next time, use the Visa check card instead of checks. It'll get you in, out, and on with life.
Yo.
Gee. Yo, gee.
Yo.
What's up? Chuck, I was only kidding. Gruesome, ain't it? Of course you know this means war. Air Jordan and Air Jordan.
Who'd you expect? Am I fine?
Michael Jordan was at the top of his game when he made this commercial.
This could be the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
That's all, folks.
Well, that's my line.
When this 1996 spot with Wile E. Coyote aired in Super Bowl 30, Deion Sanders was also on the field, winning his second Super Bowl ring as a Dallas Cowboy. Budweiser, Coke, or McDonald's? The votes are being tabulated. 37 Super Bowls, over 2,000 commercials, and it all boils down to one. When we return here on CBS.
What?
Cheese it. Get your own box.
How did we design the Kia Sorento to attain the highest quality? How did it get the government's highest side impact safety rating? How did we back it with such a great warranty and still price it thousands less than the competition? How did we do all this? We worked our freaking tails off. That's how. The obsessively perfected Kia Sorento. Get the 2004 Sorento starting at $18,635 after $1,000 cash back, plus $1,000 owner loyalty bonus for qualified buyers.
Here we go, steal, down the middle, 101, bang, dunk.
Did you see what I see? Because I saw a robber.
I saw it. Does anybody want a Coke?
Yeah, we got up, man.
Hey, you crazy, man, that's Corinthian leather. And use the footstool to get to the refrigerator. I'm running all over y'all like a treadmill. Can't stop it. It's bad.
That's hot.
I'm telling you, I'm just super nice in it, you know? That's all. When you nice,
that's like all a dish towel.
Before you take Prilosec OTC for heartburn, there's something you should know. You have to keep taking it for 14 days, heartburn or not. I'd rather take one Pepcid just when I need it. Pepcid Complete starts controlling acid in seconds. Or there's new maximum strength Pepcid AC. It has double the strength of original Pepcid AC. Both last all day or all night. One. Now, that's a number I can live with. Pepcid, just one, and heartburn's done.
Super Bowl's greatest commercials will continue here on CBS.
Super Bowl 38, Sunday, only on CBS.
When there's a full moon over Miami, the strangest things happen.
He called 911.
In other words, our victim called in his own murder.
And for CSI,
hang on!
It's gonna be a night they'll never forget.
Every warm body was out, and we're still outnumbered by the cold ones.
It's a hell of a way to go.
What did you do to deserve this meal?
Someone is making a statement.
CSI Miami, a new episode, CBS Monday.
I'm John O'Connor. At CBS 47 News, we call ourselves the Troubleshooters. We use that name because it stands for a commitment, a promise to bring you stories in which we uncover new information, stories where we discover something you might not know, stories like this one.
Hundreds of women come from across the country to use the technology in this lab to help them start a family.
We'll continue to dig deep and uncover new information and bring you those stories.
Burger King is doubling up on one of its best tasting meals. Right now, enjoy the taste of two delicious flame broiled Whopper sandwiches, two medium fries, and two medium soft drinks, all for just $6. It's an offer that's too good to be true. That's two delicious Burger King Whoppers, each with a flame broiled beef patty, lettuce, tomatoes, onions, pickles, ketchup, and mayonnaise on a toasted sesame seed bun. Plus, two orders of medium fries and two medium soft drinks, all for just $6. Make sure to take advantage of this offer today. Come on over. The fire's ready.
We're going to get the Caravan,
America's best-selling minivan.
Plus the dual power sliding doors.
Plus the power hatch.
Plus the four captain's chairs.
Plus the DVD.
Plus the 0% financing.
Or the cash allowance.
Plus the cash allowance.
Not or?
Plus.
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 Plus then.
Announcing Zero Plus, a groundbreaking offer of 0% financing plus $3,000 in combined cash allowances on Caravan. Plus our 7-year or 70,000-mile powertrain limited warranty. Hurry, Zero Plus just made the best values in America even better.
The CBS 47 News Troubleshooters exclusive in-depth investigations.
Off the floor, nothing but net. Through the window, off the wall, nothing but net.
What you want is what you get, and McDonald's today.
The second greatest Super Bowl commercial of all time is Budweiser's Zebra Referee.
This referee's a jackass.
No, I believe that's a zebra.
You know what that means. The greatest Super Bowl commercial ever is Coca-Cola with Mean Joe Green, winning both on and off the field, I might add, at Super Bowl 14 back in 1980. Instead of thanks, Mean Joe, this time, ladies and gentlemen, it's congratulations, Mean Joe. Let's take one more look now at the all-time greatest commercial Super Bowl history.
Joe.
Congratulations to the three finalists and to all the people who helped create those spots. And to all of the talented people whose commercials we've enjoyed tonight as well. I'm sure we're going to see even more memorable commercials during what promises to be an exciting Super Bowl 38 right here tomorrow on CBS. I'll be back with my guys, Dan, Dion, and Boomer, with our final thoughts in just a moment.
Do you know that they vote on these commercials?
Yeah, Pop, I'm aware of that.
So then don't mess it up.
Allergy congestion won't ruin my life again.
Claritin D, non-drowsy 24-hour tablets.
Now I can get it without a prescription.
Claritin D relieves even my worst allergy symptoms, my congestion, my sneezing, and my sinus pressure. And I can breathe.
Claritin D.
People come into H&R Block with shoeboxes jammed with receipts. It's my job to make sense of it all. So I dig through all those receipts to make sure I find them the maximum refund. That's our guarantee.
Get the maximum refund or it's free. Another advantage of H&R Block.
What's that?
The wireless bill.
Frustrated with your high wireless bill? Take your number to a better place. Call 1-800-T-MOBILE and get the best value in wireless. And now get T-Mobile 3-day weekends with unlimited calling.
T-Mobile, get more.
We gotta win this poll, Mikey.
Do we have monkeys?
No monkeys.
How about explosions?
Explosions are good.
It takes more than brains and brawn.
Stop! Police!
To fight crime in D.C.
I'm an officer of the law. I'm gonna do my job.
Sometimes it takes a little style.
Hi.
Police on the ground!
Craig T. Nelson.
82% of me is cop, the rest is miscellaneous.
Stars in The District. CBS next.
Monday, don't miss Dave's Super Bowl wrap-up. And later this week, catch Cindy Crawford and Drew Barrymore. Dave's all new all this week.
Can I have my ball back?
And this isn't even real snow.
Adam Vinatieri, kick up on the way. It is good!
All right, guys, so now we know who has won the Super Bowl of all commercials. What about the game tomorrow? We're going to have a full menu of activity here.
Yes, we are, and I'm going to have an opportunity to talk to Bill Belichick, the genius of all coaches, and also Captain Cool, that cool quarterback from the New England Patriots, Tom Brady.
The matchup you don't want to miss, Steve Smith versus Ty Law. Rodney Harris is a terror at safety. I'm going to talk to the kids of the players. I can't. Prime loves the kids.
Yeah, you absolutely do. And I get to take a step back in time. I talked to my old head coach, Sam Weish, who certainly deserves to be back in the NFL. He took us to Super Bowl 23 back in 1989. And, of course, the six defensive linemen of the Carolina Panthers who are supremely confident in their ability to close down Tom Brady and that offense of the New England Patriots.
Hey, guys, we're also on the Super Bowl today going to be joined live by President George W.
Hey,
Bush live tomorrow on CBS.
Do I interview him? Who does that?
We'll figure that one out, all right? I think you're going to draw the short straw on that one, my friend. But that does it for now from Houston. Remember, the Super Sunday begins tomorrow, 11 Eastern on CBS. Be sure to join Dan, Dion, and Boomer, my boys here. Super Bowl today at 2 Eastern, followed by the New England Patriots and the Carolina Panthers. Super Bowl 38 exclusively on CBS. Until then, Jim Nance, good night from Houston. We'll see you tomorrow. Super Bowl on CBS.
I bet. You get to do him. Why do you get to do him?
If you think these clues are bizarre,
all we've got is a tattooed leg, a sock, and a boot.
The limb itself has been dead less than 24 hours.
Wait until you see how this case ends.
Small towns, you can get away with murder.
The hell you can.
Navy NCIS, new episode, CBS Tuesday.